friends, welcome back to the channel, and may I be the first to say a very happy Halloween weekend to all of you. I hope you get tons of candy, and I hope you have a blast, and I am sure that every single one of you has the exact most perfect costume already dialed in and ready to go. Am I right? Let me show you my favorite costume from my past. Here it is. Haha, look at that guy. He's a good one. But do you know the number one costume this year that will be sported across the nation? I want you to take 10 seconds and try to guess it. Go. Whoa, I did not see that coming. We're so glad you're with us on our channel. Today, we are going to continue talking about how to relationship because that's what we do on this channel. And we believe this, if you want your life to be great, you better get relationships to be great as well because you're going to have a bunch of them. Am I right? So throughout the course of our time together, we're going to talk about all kinds of different relationships. But today, I have the opportunity to talk to you about one particular relationship that just might be the most important relationship for every single junior hire on the planet. Are you ready to hear what it is? Parents! I know, don't throw stuff just yet. Sometimes when you hear that your parents are the relationship you're gonna talk about, people go, wah, wah, I don't wanna talk about my parents. I don't even like them that much. They told me to turn off my video game. They made me come home early the other night. They don't let me go out as long as I want. They make me turn off my phone. I get it. Parents can be a bummer sometimes. I know I am one and my kids sure feel that way too. But here's what I'll tell you. If we want our lives to be great, we have to have great relationships, and the relationship you have with your parents is gonna encompass the most time of any relationship in your life. So if you want your life to be great, make this one great. And I think I might be able to help you a little bit because raise your hand out there if you feel like sometimes your parents just have too many rules. Where are you at? I know. It's rules on rules on rules. And sometimes you just feel like those rules are holding you back, right? Oh, it's such a bummer. You want to do stuff. You want to be able to do other things and they don't let you because their rules get in the way. But look, our parents get to set the rules and the consequence and everything in between. They control a lot of our lives. So how is it that we can get what we really want? What do we really want?
What do we want?
Parents!
When do we want it?
Parents!
Okay.
I think what we really want is freedom. You want to be able to stay out longer or play your video game longer or eat what you want, all the stuff you want, freedom. And sometimes we might say that freedom means the rules go away. Not always, but sometimes. Here's the story. If you want your relationship with your parents to be the absolute best that it can be so your life can be better, listen to this next little bit because I'm gonna help you see a way, like a cheat code that you can do. You ready? Let me tell you from my own life, a little story that I think is gonna help. When I was a little kid, I lived on a dead-end street. It was awesome. And when Halloween rolled around every year, there was one rule. You can walk all the way up and down the street, top to bottom, go anywhere, any house, and you don't need any parents there. Freedom! I could go anywhere, but you know what happened every single year? I'd get to the top of the street where I could turn and go get more stuff, and I would feel those rules just holding me back because I had a suspicion there was more candy out there, and I just wanted it. I was getting candy, let's go, let's go. And I felt my parents' rules holding me back from that sweet nectar. You know what I'm saying? So what did I do when my friends were like, let's go, let's get more candy. What did I do? I had a choice to make. What would you do? I'll tell you what I did. I decided to go back home just like my parents asked me to. I know, maybe that makes me lame, but listen, here's what happened. Let me just get you in on this. The next year or so, when they knew they could trust me, let me tell you what happened. They said, this year, you don't just have to stay on our street. You can go to the next street. And then it was the next street and the next street and the next street. And before you knew it, they basically just said, see ya, have fun. You guys, I learned something super important is that when I obeyed my parents' rules and gave them that honor, they gave me what I really want, freedom. When I gave honor, I got freedom. And I think the exact same is going to be true in your life, at least for most of you. But you know what? I didn't come up with that little thing by myself, give honor, get freedom. The first place I ever saw that was in the Bible. Let me show you in the book of Ephesians chapter 6 and verses 1 through 3. It says this, children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor your father and mother, which is the first commandment that comes with a promise. Now, let's just stop for a second. When they say commandment in that verse, do you know what that means? You know what they're talking about? They're talking about the 10 commandments. This is one of them. Honor your father and mother. I bet you know others like don't murder, don't steal, all that stuff. 10 commandments. But this is the first one that comes with a promise. What's the promise? Well, here it is. Verse 3. The promise is this. When you honor your father and mother so that it may go well with you and that you may live a long life on the earth. You guys, this is the promise from God. When you honor your mom and dad, it goes well with you. Things go better. Things that you want, they're more accessible to you. Why? Because this is a commandment with a promise. And I believe to my core that when you honor your parents, you get what you want. You get freedom out of that. Now listen, I think for a lot of us today, we might be like, okay, great, I'll try that. Well, the hard part is where do we start? Like, that's the difficult part about this is like, I want that. I want the freedom. So what do I do? Let me just give every last one of you one step to take today. Just one thing to do. Can you stick with me for that? Here it is. Are you ready? And because it's Halloween, let's make it a little scary. Is that cool too? Can we like have a little scare? Okay. Be prepared to have a crazy scare in 3, 2, 1. Did it work? Didn't work, did it? Okay, whatever. Moving on. All right, everybody, bring it in. I know. That was creepy. Okay, I'll finish with this. Let me give you one step to take. Everybody, say one step to take. Awesome. You know, I kind of feel like for a lot of us in the room, you know what we do? It's like we wear a mask around our parents. Masks help us do a few things. It helps us be sneaky, helps us be deceptive, kind of keeps our real identity hidden. But let me tell you something. Over the course of time, nobody wants to be around someone who's being sneaky, someone who's being deceptive. For you around your parents, maybe that sneakiness or that deception just means that you're trying to get away with stuff. You're trying to do stuff around your friends and not let your parents find out. Or you're trying to do the bare minimum when your parents ask you to do something like, hey, clean your room. And you're like, oh, okay. And you just shove stuff under a bed or something. That's being sneaky or deceptive. You got the mask on, but let me tell you what will change everything, everything about your relationship. It's when you choose to take the mask off, when you're just you. Let me give you 3 ways that you can do that, even this week. Ready? Super simple things, and then we'll get out of here. Here they are. Number 1, when your parents ask you to do something, just do it the first time they ask. Do it to the best of your ability. Whatever it is, if it's like, hey, go clean your room, then do it. Clean your room, make it look awesome. If it's like, hey, go pick up after the dog in the backyard, do it and make it look awesome. Whatever it is, do it the first time to the best of your ability. This is gonna help your parents know that you are actually listening to their words and you're obeying what they say. You're showing them honor. They'll love that. Here's the second thing you can do. Go over and above. Whatever they say to do, do a little bit more. So if they say clean your room, like dust it or like clean your window, do something like that that shows that you're willing to go over and above. And that way you're gonna show them that you see yourself as like an active participant in your family. They're gonna love it. Here's the third thing that you can choose to do. Now this one's a little awkward the first time you do it, but if you do it a couple of times, like I think you're gonna start to get onto it and your parents love this. Here it is. Ask your parents questions about themselves. especially about themselves when they were in seventh grade or eighth grade. Hey mom, hey dad, what was it like to be a football player, a cheerleader, a basketball player? What was it like to play in the band? What was it like to do dance class? Whatever it was that they were into, show an interest in them. They are going to feel so connected to you and realize that they have influence on you and that you actually like care about them. When you start to do these small things, you're not being sneaky, you're not being deceptive, you're building trust. And that is when your parents are going to realize that you're showing them honor. And when you do that, what happens? You start to feel more freedom. You guys, this is like a cheat code to end all cheat codes if you'll just do it. When you show honor to your parents, you get freedom. Now look, I know for a lot of us out there, sometimes talking about parents can be painful, emotional, can be hurtful because our parents aren't like great in our lives. I get it. But here's the reality. No matter what your parental situation is, if you want your life to be the best it can be, this relationship, maybe more than any other relationship with another person in your life, has to be getting better all the time. It doesn't have to be perfect, but I believe you can make it great. Huge distinction. Not perfect. Make it as great as it can be. You can do this. Why wouldn't you want to try? Here's one way to do it. All right? Try that this week. Have a happy Halloween. I hope it's a great time. We'll see you next time right here back on the channel. See you then.